We have a couple of announcements. Pastor Olson is on vacation and sabbatical now until early September. So if you have a need, you can send an email to session@church-creek.org, or you can contact the deacon of the month. This month, that's Jeff Bell. I want to welcome Pastor Steve Walton. He's going to be leading our worship today. Steve is an assistant pastor at First Scots Presbyterian, our sister church in Beaufort. So before moving to the Low Country last year, Steve served for 7 years as a church planter and organizing pastor of Covenant Fellowship Church, which is a PCA church in Stuttgart, Germany. He's a graduate of Greenville Theological Seminary and also serves as a chaplain in the U.S. Army Reserve. So he and his wife Hillary have been married for 25 years and have two adult sons, Samuel and Branch. So welcome, Pastor Steve.
Stand and sing the glory of God. And share in the means of grace, we might go and serve you throughout this week.
What do you need to know in order to live and die in the joy of this comfort?
First, how great my sins and misery are. Second, how I am delivered from all my sins and misery. Third, how I am connected to God for such deliverance.
And in the first couple of phrases of that, we're reminded of the need that we have to come before God, communicate with Him about our sins and our misery, and how great our need is, and to seek His help through grace. So let's pray together. We're going to use the printed prayer that's found in your bulletin. Let's use that now to approach the Lord in prayer and confess our sins. Our Father in heaven, we come to you to acknowledge and confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with all our heart and soul, with all our mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. But you, Lord, are gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. There is forgiveness with you. Bind up the broken, give light to our minds, strength to our wills, and rest to our souls. Speak to each of us the word we need, and let your word abide with us until it has taught in us your holy will. This is what we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our words of assurance and pardon come from the 130th Psalm, where in verses 3 and 4 we read, "If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness, that you may be feared." Thanks be to God. You, as a congregation of the Lord Jesus Christ, are among the Israel of God. And so as we read later in Psalm 130, you can rest assured, if you are trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ today, that with God there is steadfast love, and with Him there is plentiful redemption. He will redeem you, Christians, from all your iniquities. Thanks be to God. Am I leading congregational prayer?
Rush to get things done this morning. I forgot to mark in the order of service exactly where the congregational prayer was. So, put me off guard there just a bit, but I'm happy to be here. Paul exhorts us in Philippians 4, saying, "Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I will say rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." So let's pray together. Father in heaven, we do rejoice that in Christ we can come to you in prayer and bring our request to you. We ask that you would hear our prayer this morning and that you would guide us by your Spirit as we pray. Heavenly Father, there is so much that is uncertain, and we see so much that makes us anxious in our world today. Help us to remember that you work all things to our good. Help us to face our present troubles with confidence and look to the future with great hope of work or underemployed. So many people have been affected by the coronavirus and how it's affected the economy. We lift them up in prayer, and again, we ask that you would help us to remember how you provided for us in the past, that we might be at peace today. We pray for those who mourn the loss of loved ones. We pray for the Snows, for Kayleen Morrell, Jim Brooks, the Beckers, and especially this morning, we lift up the Schulers to you in prayer as they mourn the loss of their son. We ask that you would comfort them and grant them the peace that surpasses all understanding. Pray for those who are sick, for Charles Howell, for Warren Baldwin, for Trudy White. We ask for your comfort and your healing for these dear ones, that you would give their doctors wisdom and comfort and strengthen those who love and care for them. Father in heaven, we all have fears. Help us to show loving compassion and kindness to those who are anxious. And in our church, as we look to the future, we pray that you would help us gather and worship you in unity of spirit and brotherly love for your glory. The whole world seems to be in turmoil. There seems to be no end in sight.